What's up, y'all? It's your girl MJ, aka the Barefoot Hooper. I know it's been a minute, okay? Life kind of hit me, threw like a fireball at me, and you feel me? I was like dodging them and shit. But yeah, you feel me? I'm here, I'm back. And I know last episode we were talking about healthy relationships. We're probably gonna continue that, but I'm gonna just talk. You feel me? So today I'm going to basically talk about dreams. And I don't mean the dreams that, you know, we do when we sleep in. No, not those ones. The dreams that we kind of attain as a child, and they gradually start to kind of build, and they either start falling down and we just stop trying to catch them, or we still go after it and stuff. And so let's get into it, okay? Oh, also don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Talk about my dreams, like, growing up. So a basketball has always been in my hand since I was like 4. You know, anybody who kind of knows me knows that. With that being said, when I was in high school, I was, you're 14 in high school as a freshman, so 14 or 15. So when I was a freshman, I wanted to play varsity. I wanted to play at the highest level, you know what I'm saying? Boom, I did it. So after I got to varsity high school, the varsity team, you know, in high school as a freshman, my senior year, I wanted to go to a Division I. I fought for it, and I got it, okay? After college, the D1, I wanted to go overseas so that I could play professionally and kind of just build a name for myself so that I could be in America and get paid playing basketball and be around my family. The only opportunity to do that was the WNBA, right? And so that was my goal. So I went to Cyprus, and I went to Athens, Greece. Athens, Greece, like I said in my previous videos, it was during COVID. So COVID kind of halted everything. And then TikTok came about. And basically, I'm saying all of this because TikTok and my social media influencing kind of changed my perspective, as well as my spirituality, because I didn't want to pick up a basketball anymore because I thought I had to get a 9-to-5. I didn't really have many people knowing my talents or anything. So I just knew I needed to get money, and I needed to pay bills. You know what I'm saying? This world will either force you to let go of that dream that you attain or you hold inside your little heart, and force you to get a job, force you to do, you know, things that you don't necessarily want to do, things that don't really bring you happiness. And so with that being said, as I got older and I started to, you know, hold on to this WBA dream, I went overseas, and that was still the plan when I was in Athens, Greece. Unfortunately, the news reports and everything started kind of going crazy about COVID, and, you know, bodies is dropping, and I was scared. I think everybody was scared at that point, you know, like, what is life? So once COVID kind of hit, you know, and the world's kind of on lockdown, that's when I grabbed the ball and I started dribbling on beat. It's when I really got super spiritual and connected to, like, what brought me happiness, you know what I'm saying? Like, and what fulfilled my soul and helped my soul ascend, which is very, very, very hard to do when there's so much outside noise and just 3D, you know, material around you everywhere. The way I view things is just completely different now. So like I said earlier, that I wanted to be in the WNBA. Once I kind of got connected and I understood life for what it was, and we tend to live our lives based on the opinions of others or the acceptance of others, I no longer wanted to be in the WNBA. But with that being said, I had to let go of it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you guys kind of watched the Kaepernick documentary of when he was talking about being in the NFL and how it kind of is a form of slavery. I don't want to go down in that route, but playing in the WNBA is just not something that I want to do anymore. It doesn't really hold any more of my aspirations, really, because when I was in organized teams and an organized system with a coach involved, every single coach kind of tried to limit me, and they tried to tell me what I could do and what I couldn't do. If I made them upset, they wouldn't play me. After I got connected and on this spiritual journey, as you guys see, without the shoes, I get to play when I want. You know what I'm saying? Open my eyes to understand that what we want and what we cherish and idolize sometimes isn't, you know, what you really, really, really want. In my past experiences with coaches and things of that sort, it gets very tricky when someone gets to tell you when you get to play and how you get to play. I don't like to talk about the past, but you know, I was leaving the nation in threes at one point, and my coach had an infatuation with me that was very inappropriate. And as soon as that got out and leaked, because I was openly talking to my team about it, he stopped playing me. When it came out, I was a sophomore in college. I stuck out the years and I still did pretty well under the circumstances. Had I had a coach that fully supported me in an appropriate way, not in an inappropriate way, I probably could have made it. But I'm super glad and I'm super blessed that it did not work in that way, because I had to chase my dreams. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had to really catch them and hold on to them, but also let go of a dream that I thought I wanted. And the reason I'm talking about this is because I don't know if, you know, you guys have any family members or, you know, people that are the closest to you or the ones that you want to be closest to you. They kind of, you know, distance themselves or kind of make you seem like a problem. My brother told me that, you know, I'm a failure because I'm settling. And the reason he says that is because I'm not in the WNBA. I want to speak up and let you guys know that just because it was a dream when you were a little kid does not mean that you are a failure if you do not accomplish it. I'm sorry. It does not mean if you let go of that dream when you were as a child and you let go of it and you are doing something that is bringing you the happiness, is bringing you the peace, and is bringing you ultimately what you wanted when that was your dream, it doesn't make you a failure. And I want to share my story and share my voice with you guys, because it's important to understand that just because someone else has a certain view on you or has a certain view on what you do or what you don't do, it doesn't make it right. You choose to do what you want to do, okay? This is your life, your dreams. So if it's your dream, you have the right to either let go of it or change it. It's okay, because it's a part of life. Sometimes, you know, whatever you choose to do in this lifetime and down here is up to you. Like, you're not here to live for anybody else but yourself. I hope my brother sees this. I wanted to just reiterate that I chose to let go of the WNBA because with as many coaches that I have had in the past, I probably have on one hand, I could count how many like amazing coaches that really inspired me to be just, I don't know, just, you know, unstoppable, I guess. There are those, you know, coaches who kind of control you. And so once COVID kind of hit and I was able to pick up a basketball, make a name for myself, get paid doing it, and help those thrive in that direction, I don't think I would choose anything else really, because I'm doing it. I didn't have to settle for a normal 9-to-5. I didn't have to, you know, do anything that makes me unhappy. I'm doing things that bring me peace and prosperity, and I'm spreading God along the way. So yesterday was just very overwhelming for me, to say the least. You know, I have a few broken relationships going on in my life that I am dealing with currently, but my brother being one of them. But it is what it is. I'm always sending positive energy to him. I'm always, you know, asking for God to guide me in the direction that he wants me to take. And this is the one that he wanted me to take. I didn't force it. I didn't need to overwork myself too hard. I literally just grabbed a ball and just wanted to have fun. And I just happened to forget my shoes. Y'all messed with it a little bit. It made you guys focus in on me. And that's what I continue to do. I am going to continue to do. I want to show you guys that anything is possible, you know, and it's okay to change your dream. Like, my dream was to get paid playing basketball. Like, the WNBA was the only way that you could get paid playing basketball. And so once TikTok happened for me, and well, not for me, for the world, it ultimately ended up happening for me, and it just fell into my lap because, you know, I'm able to spread God, dribble basketball, hoop, and get paid. And I'm building a legacy for myself so that my family and my kids, if I have kids, will be okay. And who knows? You know, I'm only 26.
You don't wear shoes. Can you really play basketball?